Om Namo Bhagavate Shri Arunachala Ramanaya 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 Om Namo Bhagavate Shri Arunachala Ramanaya
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. You are that absolute. You're always perfect. You don't need any modification of any type. Knowing yourself is only just giving up false identification with things, with body. With mind. Body and mind is not perfect. Perfect is changeless. You are changeless. You are what you are seeking. Already you are that. You are that pure gold, without any shape, without any form. Remember, when you try to take a shape or you stay as a shape, all this world, you as a human being, and God as a distant reality, all manifest. But when you don't take any shape, stay as what you are, formless, nameless, pure witness, then everything disappears. Everything is a dream, an image. And you are at the source. You are the source. You are always this source. Even if you stay as an entity for next millions of years, you cannot change the truth that you are the source. For whatever duration you are dreaming, you stay as what you are in spite of a dream. Only difference is you realize who you are when the dream breaks, when the dream is over, or during the dream you know that you are dreaming. But even when the dream is going on, you are that absolute. Remember, seeker is false. Watch this seeker. Otherwise, whole life you will be a seeker. Seeker has to dissolve. Seeker is only a reflection. Reflection in the mind. To dissolve this seeker, be still. You are this pure seeing. When you stay as pure seeing, all the drama of seeker and seeking is so clear to you. To be absolute, you don't have to do anything. But to lose it, you need to do something. You need to create a doubt, act like you are seeking. Identify with your thoughts, act on those thoughts, and behave like a body-mind complex. With all its attachment, desires, you have to do a lot of stuff. To move out of absolute. But if you don't act like a doer, you don't identify with the body mind. You don't engage with your thoughts and you stay as what you are. Then you are that absolute. In this infinite universe, there are infinite number of universes, planets. They keep changing. They are vast. But all these are happening on that awareness, which is unchanging, which is timeless. You are that unchanging awareness. You are pure intelligence. Everything comes out of this pure intelligence, this emptiness. To know yourself, stay still, don't move, don't take any shape, any form, any identity. Name given to you is given to a form. That name is not your name. That image is not your image. And all the work that image is doing is not your work. Be clear on that. Very clear. And this clarity cannot come by intellectual understanding, by trying to grasp from the mind. This clarity can come only by being still. Be still all the time. In good and bad times of this body, you stay still. You will have craving to step down and take the shape cravings coming from the mind with your conditioning. And what we call as Maya, this vast network of illusion, this vast network of illusion is running the whole show, treating you as an image. If you identify with this moving image, then you are caught in this network, in this net of illusion. But if you stay still, you slip out of it and stay still. Until last breath in this body, and you will be eternally free. Stop worrying about these instruments called as body mind. It has a job to accomplish. It has a timeline. And then it will disappear. Your friendship with something which is disappearing soon will drown you too, because of your identification with it. You stay still in your pure awareness. All the time. Till your last breath in this body. You have to be aware, vigilant, and still. No thought has any value. No thought is for you. Mind is the operating system whose job is to produce thoughts. You stay still. Get completely absorbed in your stillness. This lively, pure silence. Auspicious silence. Silence is the language of divine, your own divinity. Embrace it. Even if you lose speech, doesn't matter. Like for Bhagavan, it took him years to start speaking again. How much he was absorbed in his own stillness. How deep he went into this silence. He didn't use these faculties of mind, of his speech. Why can't we all be like that? Take a deep plunge in your own silence. Go deeper and deeper and deeper. Leave aside all these gadgets, mind, intellect. Have trust in your own seeing. Have more trust in your own seeing rather than books and techniques. whether your eyes are open or closed. You cannot lose yourself. When you are working or speaking, you cannot lose yourself. Even when you have to think about something, you cannot lose yourself. Always count yourself first. Always pay attention on yourself first. Do all actions, even involvement in thoughts, from self. In awareness. Then you are always free. Even when you are using mind, thoughts, doing actions from the body, a person has awareness doing actions, never feels pressure of anything, because he does not take shape as a doer. He stays as awareness. Let the actions happen as awareness. Let the mind do its job. This is quite easy to do. Because this is not doing, this is undoing. When you agree with all results of actions, then the mind stops working. Mind gives suggestions only to the one who is looking for results in a particular way. With intense desires, awareness has no desire. As awareness, you are desireless because you are already complete, absolute, perfect and complete awareness is not seeking anything from anyone for any reason, but still some actions will be happening. Till there is a body, and awareness have no issues with it. It never creates obstacles in path of actions if they have to happen. Awareness is in total acceptance of whatever is happening or not happening. This is perfect bliss. Bliss of acceptance. You are complete stillness. Nothing can make you restless. Any situation, which is disturbing, which you think is taking away your peace, is your acid test, is grace of God, grace of your own pure self, to keep checking whether you stay as awareness, or you are still investing in ego mode. All what we call suffering is grace to keep checking on us. So we firmly abide in self. Without reactions. Staying still. Don't underestimate the power of this stillness. Stillness is the source of everything, not just your own body, mind, everything seen or unseen. And when you speak from there, you act from there, or you stay there only, you are in perfect harmony with everything. Even the mistakes of the body would be part of perfect harmony when you stay as awareness. If you believe in God, it's none other than you. This is non-duality. The God you praise, respect, love, adore is none other than you. You are that Absolute. You cannot be both. You cannot be a person and Absolute. But yes, when you decide to be a non-doer, to be a witness, to be still, then you transcend everything what is coming from a person. And yes, you are an Absolute. But then Absolute will not cry for petty things. Absolute cannot be selfish. Absolute will not be craving for petty things. Absolute cannot mistreat others. Absolute cannot have greed, jealousy, hate, fear. Absolute cannot have desires, attachments. Everything is coming from Absolute. So he is attached to everything or nothing. He treats everything as its own or nothing as its own. It's same. If it has interest in the body, then it has interest in all bodies, all images, or in none. Everything is absolute. No shades. No ifs or buts. Whole infinite world is your family. There are no strangers. Everything is your own creation. Even the beings who don't like you. Everything is your own projection. You are the creator. How can you hate anyone? And so is the unconditional love for everything. All the qualities of Absolute will come to you naturally if you stay still. All what you are not will dissolve. Enjoy this life as awareness. And you will always be in perfect harmony with everything. If you have decided to be pure seeing, who can take you away from this seeing? Who can take you back to personhood? Who can dare to do that? Even if someone hangs you to death, they cannot make you come back to personhood. Nothing in this world has energy and power to pull you back. If anything has that energy, you are giving that energy to that thing. If you decide to stay still, nothing can move you. You have to be firm in this pure seeing and stay still. Whatever comes and goes, pay importance only to awareness, to stillness. Invest all your time and energy in awareness, in stillness. Speak from here. Act from here. This should be your reference point rather than your mind. Everything should be brought in your heart before you speak or act. Always. Om Shanti Shanti.